teacher. He is a bad teacher. We are all accountable to Allah and to the community and to the government. None of us is above the law, and none of us is untouchable, and none of us has wahi from Allah to be given to him or to her, and you are not questionable. No, everybody is questionable. Everybody is touchable. Everybody is accountable. Once your organization become able to let the idea be owned by the community, definitely your organization will mature to the level of an institution. An institution is not a name. I created an organization yesterday, said that an institution of so and so. So what? An institution means ownership of the community to your organization. So you open all the doors of your organization to the community to choose the president, to choose the structure, the leadership, even to develop your ideas. What is the role of an institution, which is a mature organization, is to change the idea into ideology. So the fourth or fifth arrow will go to another circle called ideology. You have an idea, initiative, organization, an institution, ideology. Clear? Just one slide. This ideology will be owned by the country or by the society or by the tribe or by whatever it is. What does it mean? What ideology you spread? Islam? In Islam, what it is? Communism? What it is? Liberalism? What it is? Secularism? But it took a long time to develop this idea of one man to become an ideology. It might take you 30, 40 years at least. Clear? Is it clear? After that, this ideology will be changed with the community ownership of your ideology. Be the beginning, 50, 60, 70, 80, you nurtured it and focus on growing it, not focus on the farmer. Focus on growing it after 60 and 70, which awake. Clear? But number six is culture. What circle now with you? What is number six called? Huh? Culture. The arrow goes to, after culture, is Nahda, which is Renaissance. It is a cycle. Idea, initiative, organization, institution, ideology, culture, Nahda, Renaissance, civilization, and history. You can make history. I will conclude in about 2-3 minutes now by saying our problems in our organizations, that we do not question them, that we, whether they talk about hadith or Quran and whatever it is, that to worship clans, this our group, that's why we never get our idea to be owned by, we said this is our jama'ah, this is our development for you, to you. And I was challenged because I don't have any everything. There's no need for clapping. I believe in quality of people. How many? Community center. Wait for people to come. Half an hour or so, another woman used to come. Another English. French. Yes, brother. Come here, come here.
Circle of your goal. Okay. So, Bhaskar's people.
He's asking, what are the ways?
Is it painful?
Yes.
This is number one. Number two, patient. Patient, patient. Hazrat whom? Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam conveyed the message, OCUS. Don't go all over the place. Shall I give cult? To achieve. Step by step, slowly and progressively. Don't give big promises. Big dreams to the community. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you.
Any other question, brothers? Yes, come here. We have the television, we have BBC. We have BBC here, we have CNN, we have ENN. ENN is my channel. And we have INN. Come on. Say your question. Are you, where are you from? Are you Pakistani?
Yes, I'm Pakistani.
Very good. I'm Pakistani as well. Go on.
So, the main thing is that different people have different ideas, but the main thing is they're not motivated.
I see.
Like they think that their idea will not work in the future. So what will you say about that? How we can motivate people? Like I'm doing for different competitions. So I feel that students are not that much. They have ideas. They have that like great ideas, but they die with those ideas. They don't implement it. So what will be the motivation for them? How can we motivate people?
The first step of motivation is the success of a simple idea. You have competition. You want 1,000 people to participate. Start with 5. Start with 3. And go on. Do you have to see the full? No, start with 1 acre, with 1/2 acre. It depends on how much ability you have. If you put, as I mentioned to the brother before, higher target, this will demotivate you because you'll not be able to do it. You want to educate all the people, the children, in a village which have got 30 or 40, so dump them. So maybe you start or a motorbike or something like and on. Motivate yourself, don't put high target. Okay? Says, I can do. I always tell the sisters, if you marry your husband today, will you have a baby at the tomorrow? I love you. Huh?
Thank you, sir.
No, class or third class, no, not very good. 83. Brother, your brother or uncle, Maulana Swaib? Your brother. You look like me, huh? The first khutbah is the first. It was about the farm of Africa, Birmingham University. So we raised, we made a bank account.
Yes, sir.
And we went from street to street, from door to door. Now, it, at that time, no. Did anybody know me in the university with a colleague? Alhamdulillah, I got his doctorate, and I got my doctorate as a token from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there was no, you know this? We didn't have a question box on the wall. And we used to go every Saturday to the Islamic Circle to it and to £5, £10, £20, £50, £100. And the biggest donation came to us was in August 1984, or not. So you have people. Your people might not be highly educated. So they might not accept what you're talking about. So you have to take the people step by step. You have to understand that not everything is happening in certain country and successful will succeed in your country. Because those people are different to your people. Those people have got different culture to your culture. Those people have different organization to your organization. Those people have different leadership to your leadership. You learn from them what suits your society. You learn from them what suits your society. Okay? Thank you.
Junior.
Yeah, we can learn from them as well. What's the problem? I love Nelson Mandela.
Huh? Sir, inke bare mein main matlab keh raha hu ke inke kaam jo the unko lekar aage hum new nation new hum jo hain chale to kya tarakki kar sakte hain aur kis tarah se kaun sa theek hai zyada.
Okay,
what? Nizam kaun sa theek hai zyada?
He says among the different leaders, which one is more successful according to your opinion, which should we follow? Which one of these?
No, I'll tell you something. Yeah, I'll tell you something. You see, you judge leaders after they die. Of his nation, it was actually that the war machine was killing and raping the Bosnian people of what you have done. I respect theologian like and revolutionary like what you call it, Dr. Martin Luther King, which is actually starts the revolution for the rights, the civil liberty of the black people in America. He's not a Muslim, but we respect him. Okay, The same like Malcolm X. Okay? And all those, Che Guevara. You know Che Guevara? And all those people have to learn from them. We have to respect them. Because in their life, they dedicated, that's what I told earlier on, no matter how good or bad your idea, if you are committed and dedicated and believe in it.
Management of the Islamic Relief and the whole charity. What is the perspective for Pakistan and, of course, the rest of the world?
Oh my God, this is another lecture. The mission is behind Islamic Relief is when you focus on the needy. Don't focus on how big the organization is, how many offices. When we started in 1984, we were looking, you see, as I mentioned this morning or sometime, my dream was in the good old days to work in Pakistan, because it's Pakistan, in an area called Northwest Frontier, not KPK, in an area called Balochistan. I never been to Pakistan before 1997. But I, with my colleagues, wanted to go to Northwest Frontier, Kashmir, Sindh, and Balochistan, especially Balochistan, Northwest Frontier and Kashmir. This is the deal. Okay, that was the vision. Alhamdulillah, nowadays, they were working, Islamic Relief is working in these four or five provinces. Okay, this number one. You focus, you keep meeting the poor people, which give you the energy.
Okay.
And give you the fuel to carry on.
Yes.
Okay. If you don't mix with them and put yourself inside a room, you will be a desk sitting on a desk. A screen, so looking at a screen. The more you visit people, that's why the Prophet when Hazrat Jibreel came and told him, you know what he told him? Do you want to be a king, a prophet king or king prophet? Or you been be a slave prophet? He said, Prophet Hazrat Jibreel told him, advise him to become a slave prophet. And to, he was making a dua, saying, oh Allah, make me among the miskeen. Make me among the miskeen. He could become the king of the kings, isn't it?
Yes.
But he refused because he wanted to respond to the needs of the most needy. When you respond, this will go electric.
Yes, of course.
When it becomes electric, you give me a shock.
Yes, of course. Thank you.
Zakallah khair. Not the king, not the president will electrify you. It is the poor people in the city.
Thank you. If no further question, I thank the speaker and I request the